Stretch, stretch. You can put it on the board. Yes.
Welcome to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from the amp.tv mobile studios here in fabulous Las Vegas. That's AAMP.tv. Today's show is brought to you in part by Cali Vegas, helping people create and host their very own radio, TV, or multimedia talk show. Cali Vegas can help them with getting out of traffic every day and getting into their own studio every day. Now you don't have to commute to work. For more information, contact Cali Vegas at 949-445-1119. That's 949-445-1119. Again, 949-445-1119. Or visit them online for more information at calivegas.com. That's CaliVegas.com. And a big welcome to everybody listening in on Magic 97.9 FM right here in Las Vegas, as well as our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast. Talk 1490 WIRB down in Southern Alabama, the Florida Panhandle, Spotify, iHeartRadio, and those watching us, of course, on Hotel Television and AMP TV. Joined by two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior, looking all snappy and sharp, as always. There he is, giving me all the moves. On TV, you can see that. That's Tyrone Poole. Thanks for joining us.
Hey, Sal. It's nice to be on the show with you. Moves. I know, right? Hey, you got to give me a fist bump. I get a fist bump. Fist bump. There we go, right to the side. There you go, Sal. All right, we got it.
You're giving me an elbow bump there. You're not giving me a fist bump.
Yeah, okay. There you go. Right there. There you go. Right there. There you go. There you go. All right.
That's funny. All right, so hey, man, listen. We had a great show with Mario Andretti last time around. Who has the ability to bring on superstar guests like him and yourself, by the way?
Hey, I'm just an ordinary person that just happened to have had an extraordinary job. But like you said, bringing on guests like Mario Andretti, oh man, he's an icon. I'm like, we got so many people from the past, and guess what? The future, oh man, it's bright. Got a lot of people. So don't be surprised if you don't, you know, one day you see Tom Brady or, you know, maybe Belichick. I don't know. Somebody may call in from the Patriots, you know. I don't know. Maybe here in Atlanta. You know, we never know. So you got to tune in, though. You got to tune in. iHeartRadio, AMP TV. Don't miss the show, because you're going to miss some great people.
So I love the conversation about going fast. You know, you were a hell of a lot faster than I was. I was a track star in high school, but you had gone above and beyond that. And of course, doing it on the football field, you know, taking interceptions from away from people and stuff like that. But the conversation of going fast was fun. I loved that.
It was.
And you and I have both had a similar experience in a car going 160 yes. miles an hour on our own without any real supervision here. You know what I mean?
I know, Sal. And, you know, just to have Mario talk about speed, I just remembered it took me back to the Nissan 300ZX. I know a lot of people, listeners right now,
those are viewing.
You had a Nissan 300? Oh, man. I'm like, you asleep?
I had an 85-300ZX. I had an 85-300ZX.
Oh, yeah, because they went from the long nose ZX to the round, curvy type 300ZX, and it had 160 on the dash. So guess what I'm going to do? I'm going to see Kenny go 160. Exactly. Right. I want to see that Kenny really go. So I'm going back to my college, and there's a stretch of road that I can see clear for about at least a mile or two. And you talking about looking around, making sure there are no police officers, no speed traps. I'm in fourth gear. I said, okay, left foot, press that clutch in, swing that gear shift to the outside, fifth gear, overdrive. Now, you know the telegram poles, the light poles, they got to be at least, 50, maybe 100 yards apart. Well, when I got up to when I got up to about 160, Sal, those telegram poles looked like they were 2 feet apart. That's how fast I was going. And I'm like, you know what? I got to back off. It was going too fast. Now, I know you like speed too. So what's your story, your fast story?
Yeah, man. I had a later in life, I had the long nose 300ZX. I have one of those, 1985.
Those were nice.
And I love that car. It was a money pit, but I love the car. It had the T-tops, like the old school 280Zs. Remember those?
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
I have one of those. But my speed story is I would drive, for example, down from Chicago down to West Lafayette, Indiana, to go see a football game for my undergraduate. That would be Purdue University. Big round of applause for them.
Purdue Boilermakers.
Go Boilers. And so, in fact, I went while Drew Brees was there. Drew Brees was a freshman when I was a senior. And so on my way down there, it was construction. So they had those long cement walls where you can't get in, you can't get out for miles and miles, right? So if you broke down, I mean, the whole thing's going to be logjam. But I remember going down there in an AMG 65, and, buddy, it said 200 on the speedometer, right?
Wow.
I'm thinking, okay, let's have some fun with this. Buddy, I hit it to 160, and I had a lot of room to go to the floor. And, in fact, I was going so fast. For me, what I pay attention to is I look at the brakes in the lines in between lanes. And, you know, they're going really fast, really fast. When you're going fast, it almost gets to the point where you know you're going too fast when those broken lines become a solid line. Uh-huh. You know what I mean?
Oh, that's too fast. Yes.
Yeah. It's kind of like those poles, the telephone poles or the light poles. When you're going by so fast, it looks like one big pole.
Yeah, one pole with a telegram pole, light pole, poles a pole. All I know is when you're going fast, they become one. So like you said, with that line. So, yeah, so that's fast, man. But those are things that I like football, you play baseball, any athlete. I think even on your job as a regular person that – when I say regular person, you have a 9-to-5. Sometimes they consider athletes – that's not a true 9-to-5, but really it is. But it's like there are certain things that get my adrenaline going. And speed is one. And I would say jumping out of an airplane, which I have not done, but I can tell it will get your adrenaline going. So I'm like, those are just some of the things that I – love doing, plus the flyover, you know, just the military, when the flyover during the game or before the game, after the national anthem, those are things that get my adrenaline going. So, speed, yes.
Tyrone, have you ever had the opportunity to go bungee jumping?
You know what? Only at Six Flags, and I didn't like it too much. I had to take it easy, the safe one, baby steps first, Sal, baby steps. But I'm pretty sure you got the adult version that you want to tell us about.
I did. As a matter of fact, right here in Las Vegas, as a matter of fact, I was eating a meal with a buddy of mine at a Mexican restaurant right across the street from the circus. And they had a bungee tower, 181 foot high, you know, 18 stories high. It's pretty high up there. And so,
it's this high.
So we're watching the people fall, splash into the pool. And I was like, damn, look at that. And so having a couple of margaritas and having all kinds of real heavy food happened to be like a Taco Tuesday or something. But nonetheless,
Taco Tuesday.
After getting after having a couple of drinks in you and saying, oh, yeah, I could do that. All right. So we walk across the street to get a little bit closer. And I'm like, all right, man, let's go. Come on, let's go up to the top. And so we go up there. The guy goes, it's going to cost you $50. I'm like, okay, here's the $50. Yeah. I just want to see it up close. And so,
you sure you gave him 50 or did you give him 100? Because you say you were a little bit tipsy. Yeah, you say he charged you 50.
Know,
you sure you didn't give him 100? But go ahead.
I had Mr. Grant. I had Grant with me. Grant was a 50, right? And so we get up and I talk four girls into going too. Now, I'll never forget this. And I'm like, you know, I'm an eligible bachelor. That's what I want to do, right? So. You know, I'm on, girls, let's go up there. Let's get a closer look. And so before you know it, we all sign up for this thing. And I watch my buddy go down, and I'm watching him. And the only thing you can hear up there is the wind. You can't hear nothing. And I remember watching my buddy. He had gone before me, and I saw him. He's like this big. He was going, right? No. Like, hey, it was great. And I couldn't hear him because I was so far away. And then I got to the end. I was like, all right, it's my turn. So they wrap a towel between my legs, and then they put the big rubber band around your ankles, right?
And now, hold on, go back. Hold on. Hold on, Sal. What is the towel for? You say you put a towel between your legs? What's the so you don't wet on yourself?
They put a towel between your ankles so it doesn't smash your ankles together.
Yeah. Well, that was a joke. Yeah. I was saying that you don't wet on yourself. You know, you don't get nervous and wet on yourself, so you need the towel. Come on, man. Come on, Sal. Well, go ahead. Finish the story. Go ahead, Sal.
It's not for me. But anyway, so they wrap my feet up, and I inch myself to the edge. And I'm like, whoa, you know, I'm trying to hold on to something here, right? I'm trying to hold on to the microphone, hold on to everything. And the guy goes, here, do you want me to push? I'm like, no, I'll do it on my own. And so I'll tell you what, buddy, I got to the end and I'm like, okay, I just closed my eyes and leaned forward and I opened my eyes and the ground rush, the speed was incredible because you could see it. I could see the pool coming at me 100 miles an hour and you know, you're going to hit it. Right. So I hit the pool, I go half wind, and then I shot almost all the way back up, and then I had to fall again. I was so wired for 3 days straight. I couldn't sleep. There was nothing that I could have done that was better than the bungee tower itself. It was unbelievable.
Wow.
Really.
So literally you hit the water. You hit the water and went into the water.
I hit the pool and I shot back up. We'll pick that up on the other side here.
Wow.
Sports Circus.
Yeah, definitely.
It's incredible. Folks, don't go anywhere. Lots more to come here on the circus. Back in a few minutes with Tyrone Poole, two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior.
More about bungee jumping.
Do you have any questions about legal issues? Have you ever been stopped by a police officer and issued a ticket that you're scared to deal with? Have you ever been in trouble with the law and don't know what to do? Do you have a will or power of attorney question? Is your home being foreclosed upon and you don't know where to turn? Maybe you were given a contract that you don't understand. For freedom and a worry-free solution, call for Legal Shield today at 213-245-1305. It's that simple. You will have access to high-quality law firms that will fight for you for less than a dollar a day. Peace of mind is just a call away. That's for Legal Shield. Call 213-245-1305 or visit us at nocourt.us. It's justice for all and not justice for some. Are you a small business owner or pursuing the dream of starting your own company? Do you know where to start or how to grow that existing business? The American Business Trust Company has the answers you need. The American Business Trust Company can help you with startup capital, business strategy, sales and marketing, and establishing your company with a physical location or on the internet. You decide. You bring the idea. The American Business Trust Company can help with the rest. For a free evaluation, you may visit them online at abtrustco.com. That's abtrustco.com or call them at 657-600-1876. That's the American Business Trust Company, 657-600-1876. Call them today. They can help your business right away.
This is Sal Tuzzolino, host and ringmaster of the Sports Circus. Why listen to the same old dog and pony show that you've heard all day long? The Sports Circus covers everything that other shows don't or are too scared to cover. There's no primetime show like it on air that'll punch you in the mouth and you'll beg for more. You can call in and participate with our chaos if you dare. Join me and celebrity guests for Havoc and Mayhem weekdays at 5 p.m. Pacific here on Amp TV or stream the show live at thesportscircus.com. Remember, folks, it's a circus and we prove it every day.
So, you want to be in show business. Do people tell you that you're really funny, you have a great personality, and you should have your own talk show? Many of us have been told that, but we don't know how to get started. It's easier than you think. Let the pros at Cali Vegas give you a free talent evaluation. Call 949-445-1119 and learn how quickly you can create, produce, and host your very own talk show. Imagine not having to sit in traffic every day, commuting back and forth to the same old boring job. Get started in television or radio today with your free talent evaluation from Cali Vegas. Call 949-445-1119 or visit them online at calivegas.com. Make your dream come true today and create your new career and learn how to become a television or radio star with the help of Cali Vegas. 949-445-1119. Call now.
Hey, this is Tommy John, and you're listening to the Sports Circus.
Hey,
Welcome back to the Sports Circus, live from the Amp.TV studios here in fabulous Las Vegas. That's AAMP.TV. An important message for consumers, business owners, and managers for information on the best high-speed internet, satellite TV, cell phone service, identity protection, home and business security systems and automation, credit card processing, and savings on electricity and gas bills. Contact 702-799-9935. That's for information on smart savings for homes and businesses. Contact 702-799-9935 or learn more at safelyspend.com. That's safelyspend.com. And welcome back to everybody listening in on iHeartRadio, Spotify, Magic 97.9 FM here in Las Vegas, and our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast, and those watching on Hotel Television and Amp TV, joined here again by two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior, Tyrone Poole. Tyrone, we were talking about bungee jumping in the last segment. Yes. Remember that one?
Hold on, yes.
And you had asked me a question.
Yeah.
And go ahead.
Yeah. I had a question. Caller number 12. I'm caller number 12, and I got a question for Sal. With the bungee jumping, when you're landing, you said you were jumping from 18 stories. That's very high, very high. I think very high. And you said you were going and you landed in a pool. Now, even though that's water, coming from that height, did it hurt? Could you have broken anything? Did that water feel like it was a brick when you hit the water before you went back up? How did it feel?
Well, so what happened is they basically tie a big rubber band around your ankles. So the rubber band will stretch until you hit that maximum stretching point, right? Think about physics. I don't know what the exact terminology is. We'll have to call in sonar for that one. But nonetheless, you'll get to that point where it will stretch to that point where it's like, okay, this is your maximum limit based on your weight. And they weigh you before they put the rubber band on you. And then you hit the pool. And then for me, in my case, I shot back up and I basically had to fall again. So I hit the pool pretty fast, but you don't even realize it happens so fast because the ground rush is incredible. And you see the ground coming right at your face. But then about 5 gallons of water seemingly goes right up your nose, and then you shot back up again, and then you're spraying water all over the place. Imagine like a dog, you know, getting rid of the water off of them. But that's all coming out of your face and stuff. It's unbelievable.
Wow. So it did not sting at all. Like, you didn't feel nothing when you hit the water? Because I'm thinking, even if I just tap myself on the back of my hand, I can feel it. So you're dropping 18 stories, and you telling me you didn't feel nothing? Maybe it was the margaritas. I think it was the margaritas that you didn't feel.
It could have been the margaritas. I don't know. But the thing is, it happens so fast that you don't even realize it happens. And Sonar, you had some training in the military as well. You had to do some pretty cool stuff for the Navy, didn't you?
Yeah.
I mean, we jumped from some pretty heights and everything else, but a lot of that was jumping into water, not as high as you did. 18 stories is quite a bit. Jumping into water, anything above 250, the water doesn't compress enough. It's like you're hitting concrete. Anything over 250 feet, it's just like you're hitting concrete. You might as well just hit a solid object, because water does displace itself, but you have to hit it hard enough or come in. That's why they do the sailor dive, where you cross your fingers and the jackknife or whatever it is. So, yeah. And then, Tyrone, back to what you're saying, the elasticity of the bungee actually slows him down back to his resting velocity. It's just all kinetic energy at that point. It's all potential energy. And then when it snaps back up, that energy comes back in as speed. But go ahead.
See, now I was going to say, for everybody watching on Amp TV and iHeartRadio, that's why we have sonar. See how he broke the electricity, potential energy. See, me and Sal, we're going to say something that the
stringiness term. of the rubber band. Yeah.
There you go. See, that's why we got sonar, Sal.
But so yeah, you can
talk to the techie people.
A human
electricity.
If you didn't have that If you didn't have that bungee, you would hit terminal velocity is essentially as fast as you can fall. I mean, after a certain point, you can't get any more speed. But what is it, 53 meters per second, somewhere around 200 miles an hour, somewhere around, or I'm sorry. Yeah, 150 to 2 miles an hour, 200 miles an hour, and that's terminal velocity for a human, and you would die from that height, not necessarily from the water, but you would probably break everything and then probably drown. I mean, really, you would drown more than you would be smashed. Because you're not going,
you'd be disoriented completely.
Oh, yeah. You better have a couple lifeguards there to help you out when you finally surface.
So let me ask you this question: this is a joke. Now, terminal velocity. So with the Flash, and Superman, when they get up to top speed beyond terminal velocity, going, I guess you would say they're going horizontal instead of down.
Yeah. So they had to worry about
the same thing.
So there's a really cool book that I think is right up your alley.
I had to ask you.
There's a really cool book. I think it's right up your alley, Tyrone. It's called The Physics of Superheroes. Really cool read. It talks about how Spider-Man swings and how fast the Flash actually goes, how many cheeseburgers he has to eat to actually maintain that speed and that energy. But you're right. The biggest thing that they've got is speed of sound first, I think is Mark 1 is 700 feet per second or 700 miles per hour or something like that. I can't remember it off the top of my head.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's the speed of sound, Mark 1. And
Mach 1 is 550 foot per second.
There you go. So I think that's about, 700 miles an hour-ish? Maybe, yeah. I don't know. I'm used to dealing with sound in the water. Sound in the water is 4,800 feet per second. That's the only number that I ever need to know.
Sal, did you have a story where you got your fastball up to Mach 1? Wasn't that?
Yeah, right.
I think you're the only person. Yeah, but they lost the data, though, right? They didn't lose the data. They lost the data. But tell us about it.
Yeah, right. No, that was like a fish story, Tyrone. Tyrone, are you a fisherman?
You know what? I took my kids fishing one time. Now, I grew up, you know, in a small town. My parents love fishing, but it never took on to me. I was always the city guy. I'm like, I always wanted to be in the city.
You know,
but I'm not a fisherman. Ask your question.
I'll tell you what. If you go fishing in the ocean, it will change your world. Because in the ocean. Okay. It will change you, because it depends on if you're going deep sea fishing for the big game stuff,
yes,
or if you're going just maybe a little bit offshore and you're in a little boat, a little skiff with a bait tank. You're like,
yep,
I'm going to throw that line down there. And buddy, I don't even know what's going to hit my line. And I've had this happen. I used to go fishing maybe a couple of times a week down in Orange County. And so we'd rent a little boat, get out there just past the jetty. And so you're out there in a little 15-foot boat bouncing around and whatnot, because, you know, the waves are kicking. And I tell you, on one day, I caught 11 different species of something. And they range from an octopus. It ranged from a spotted bay bass to a halibut, and all kind of neat stuff. And you never know. I snagged an octopus. Snagging an octopus was incredible. I snagged a starfish as well, believe it or not.
Wow. You know, I have a deep sea fishing story. Now, growing up in a small city, you know, normally they go fishing, you know, ponds and things like that, that are stocked, you know, they stock them, bass, catfish.
Right.
So the family and I, we went on vacation in the Bahamas. So the kids wanted to go deep sea fishing. So, you know, you kind of plan it out. You know, we're going to do this excursion, that excursion. So we all decided to do deep sea fishing. So I get up early. Again, I'm green. Don't know anything about deep sea fishing. And yes, I've been on boats or ships in the ocean, but never deep sea fishing. So I get up, we eat breakfast. I'm like, you know, I got to eat breakfast. I don't want to be hungry. We're going to be out there for a lot of hours. Well, like you said, the waves. That's the one thing, again, being green around the ears, my stomach could not take the waves. So I was full of food. And guess what happened? That food decided that it did not want to stay in my stomach. But I threw up. But after I threw up, I was fine for the rest of the day. So the note being, the moral of the story, do not eat if you can't handle the waves.
Oh, no, no, no.
Sea fishing.
No, eat. Eat because you feel better after you get sick. If you don't eat, you can't get sick.
Okay, well, maybe, that's right. Again, that's what happened to me. I ate, I threw up, I felt better. I was good for the rest of the deep sea fishing. Actually caught some mahi-mahi. That's what they
call it. And for all you people on the East Coast, that would be the Dorado. And for everybody over on the West Coast, that's mahi-mahi.
Yeah, dry heaving's no fun, Tyrone. I was doing the same thing. I would always get sick on the boat. And I would make sure I ate because I had to have something to get sick with.
Sick from, yeah. Wow.
We have gone a really weird direction, and thank God we're coming to the end of the segment.
It's a sports circus.
It's a circus. You never know what you're going to get here. You never know. All right, folks, we're going to be back here with two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior Tyrone Poole, best-dressed guy in the building over there. Back here in a few minutes. Don't go anywhere. Lots more to come.
Do you have any questions about legal issues? Have you ever been stopped by a police officer and issued a ticket that you're scared to deal with? Have you ever been in trouble with the law and don't know what to do? Do you have a will or power of attorney question? Is your home being foreclosed upon and you don't know where to turn? Maybe you were given a contract that you don't understand. For freedom and a worry-free solution, call for Legal Shield today at 213-245-1305. It's that simple. You will have access to high-quality law firms that will fight for you for less than a dollar a day. Peace of mind is just a call away. That's for Legal Shield. Call 213-245-1305 or visit us at nocourt.us. It's justice for all and not justice for some. Are you a small business owner or pursuing the dream of starting your own company? Do you know where to start or how to grow that existing business? The American Business Trust Company has the answers you need. The American Business Trust Company can help you with startup capital, business strategy, sales and marketing, and establishing your company with a physical location or on the internet. You decide. You bring the idea, the American Business Trust Company can help with the rest. For a free evaluation, you may visit them online at abtrustco.com. That's abtrustco.com or call them at 657-600-1876. That's the American Business Trust Company, 657-600-1876. Call them today. They can help your business right away.
This is Sal Tuzzolino, host and ringmaster of the Sports Circus. Why listen to the same old dog and pony show that you've heard all day long? The Sports Circus covers everything that other shows don't or are too scared to cover. There's no primetime show like it on here that'll punch you in the mouth and you'll beg for more. You can call in and participate with our chaos if you dare. Join me and celebrity guests for Havoc and Mayhem weekdays at 5 p.m. Pacific here on Amp TV or stream the show live at thesportscircus.com. Remember, folks, it's a circus and we prove it every day.
So, you want to be in show business. Do people tell you that you're really funny, you have a great personality, and you should have your own talk show? Many of us have been told that, but we don't know how to get started. It's easier than you think. Give you a free talent evaluation. Call 949-445-1119 and learn how quickly you can create, produce, and host your very own talk show. Imagine not having to sit in traffic every day, commuting back and forth to the same old boring job. Get started in television or radio today with your free talent evaluation from Cali Vegas. Call 949-445-1119 or visit them online at calivegas.com. Make your dream come true today and create your new career and learn how to become a television or radio star with the help of Cali Vegas. 949-445-1119. Call now.
Hey there, it's Nick Bakay. You may know me as the voice of Salem Saberhagen, the talking cat from Sabrina the Teenage Witch. You're listening to the Sports Circus. I'm on a calliope. Get me out of here. I'm scared.
We'll be right back.
Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from the Amp.TV studios here in fabulous Las Vegas. That's AAMP.TV. This segment brought to you in part by Legal Shield, providing legal protection and peace of mind. Legal Shield can help with traffic tickets, texting and driving, speeding for all those that like to drive like Mario Andretti, DUIs, court appearances, drunken public, estate planning, even contracts given to people they don't understand, plus a whole lot more. For more information, contact Legal Shield at 213-245-1305. That's 213-245-1305, or contact them at nocourt.us for more information. And a big welcome back to everybody listening in on Magic 97.9 FM, right here in Las Vegas. Our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from Honolulu on CBS Sports 1500K, HKA, all the way up to Boston on WBNW 1120 AM and 102.9 FM. A big hello to our friends over in LA, listening in on NBC News, CNBC Financial, and NBC Sports, and Westwood One News. That would be KCAA 106.5, 102.3 FM, and 1050 AM, and everybody else literally around the world, because a lot of people are streaming us on the sportscircus.com. And especially those people watching us on hotel television, you can see the mobile studio is inside one of these glorious properties. And we're not going to name where we're at. We're going to see if somebody can text in on the amp.tv text box and see if they get the right answer. All right, Tyrone, back here with two-time Super Bowl champion Tyrone Poole and American Ninja Warrior. There he is, doing his warrior stuff. All right, where do we leave off, young man?
Oh, we just... I'm just amazed at how much of this you can read off, Sal. I'm like, it's just flowing with you. It's like listening to you read poetry. It's Westwood One and NBC. Like, you just reel it off. Like, it's embedded in your brain. Do you go to bed at night thinking about, okay, this is how I'm going to say this, this is how I'm going to say that? How does it roll off your lips so adequately? Like, sonar using no big words like electricity, my big word. How does it roll off you? What do you do to be a professional like you are in this?
Look, when industry? You've done it thousands of hours, thousands and thousands over years and years, it just gets burnt into your brain. That's it. It's if I ask you, Tyrone, if I ask you, explain in 5 seconds what's a go route, and you're going to come right back and you're going to hit it right away.
I'm going to say, not as good. No, I'm just joking. Yeah, I get you.
It's that muscle memory. You can say what is a go route, but if I told you right now, if we were out in a field, Tyrone, and I was like, Tyrone, run a go route right now, your body would just know exactly what to do.
Exactly.
I used to answer phones for the network all the time, too. So I would answer my phone at the house. Sports Circus, live from KIOF 97.9 Las Vegas Public Radio, and that's my house phone, and my wife would go, well, who are you talking to? Like, that's your mom. Like, you just answered the phone like you're on the air to your mom. Get out of here.
Yeah. You know my old little cliche or my analogy, it's like when you bend your elbow. You do it so many times. You have a spoon with some food on it. You bend your elbow. Your mouth automatically opens. You don't need to tell your mouth, okay, open, choo-choo, the train is coming. Your elbow bend, mouth open. So I get it. You've done it so many times, it becomes creatures of habit.
He just wakes up in a night sweat going, Westwood One affiliate. It just sometimes you just
I don't know. It just happens. I know sometimes somebody will come to the door and say, "Welcome to the Sports Circus."
Yeah. You know, I gotta ask this question now, you know, kind of jokingly. I know we get back into sports. I know there's a lot of people say, "Hey, there's some sports stuff that you guys need to be talking about."
But don't worry about it.
I know, tell them, don't worry about it. But staying in character, okay? There's a movie, Tropic Thunder. Right. And the character, anyways, Tropical Thunder, the guy says, okay, you're staying in character. Robert Downey Jr. Thank you, Tyrone. Robert Downey Jr. He plays his character, and Ben Stiller. He says, "You're stealing character." He said, "No, I'm not stealing character." He said, "Yes, you are. Why are you still acting like the sergeant?" So my question to you guys, being in character, have you ever answered your phone or talked to your buddies where you're like stealing character? Like Sonar said, "Hey, this is Westwood One, KR." They're like, "Hold on, man. This is, talk to me normal." So have you guys ever been like that?
I've had a couple people in my line of work that actually are like that in real person. Like they'll answer their phone. My buddy, Bob Long, we used to do a show called Wheels and Deals, where essentially you'd call up and he'd tell you exactly what your car was worth and what you could get out of it. And he answered the phone. He like talked to his grandmother. He would meet people in the grocery store the same way. "Hello, my name is Bob Long. It's nice to meet you." So he would always talk like this and use his radio voice anytime he had a conversation. Oh, so you would be talking to him and he would say, "Well, I need eggs and milk and butter. And while you're at it, please pick up some of that Lysol and toilet paper. Thank you. This is Bob Long."
Yeah, I need to go to your restroom. Could you tell me what we are having for breakfast? Could you put the television on the news?
So, it's like, yeah, it's like hanging out with Dan Rather forever.
Yeah, I just tell people that if I'm out, if I have to go to the restroom when I get to the restaurant, I'll say, "I'll be back in just a couple of minutes. Don't go anywhere. My order's to come."
Oh, man. That is funny. That is funny.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, you got to do stuff like that because it's just burnt in your head. It's just what you do.
Yeah. Yeah. And you know, military people, they're like that as well. I've had people, I know people who were in the military that once they were discharged or whatever the case may be that they left or retired, they would act at home as a civilian like they were in the military. So I'm like, Sonar, I'm like, I'm pretty sure, were you like that? Like at some point, I know you say the radio voice and everything, but like your military background, did you bring that home?
Well, I mean, there's a lot of us. Well, the most common one is just hypersensitivity, just always being aware of everything that's going on around. That's one of those things we all have to shake off. The other thing is always starting when you start walking with your left foot. You march so much in basic and everything else that they instill on you that you lead with your left foot every single time. That's number one. You step off, like you step off
a
train.
I like that.
Yeah. Yeah. You step off a train. You get off the bus. You step onto a boat, which is incredibly bad luck. If you listen back to some of our previous episodes is jumping on a boat with your left foot, even though that's what they teach us. And it takes you'll be standing at a curb waiting for the light to change so you can walk across the street. And sure enough, you'll start with that left foot.
Left foot.
Folks,
wow.
in case you're wondering, here you've got a Sonar, who's our engineer. He kind of drives the bus for the show. He's in Chicago. Tyrone over here, this guy, he's over in Atlanta, and I'm here in Las Vegas. And you know, on the previous episode, we had Mario Andretti, and Mario was in Pennsylvania. So, yeah, we had four different places represented on the show. It's incredible. I love that. And, you know, there are some TV shows in the sporting world, if you know what I mean. They try to take some of our information, but we know who you are, four-letter network.
Yes.
And guess what? We know that you're listening to us. And I think it's funny because sometimes, you know, Tyrone, we should plant something that's completely off base and have their sports writers try to take it from this show. You know what I mean?
Exactly. Yeah, I don't think they can do it because sometimes they are so uptight. That's why we're so loose. That's why we could be in different places talking to Mario Andretti. We got great people that are going to come on the show, have been on the show. We got Sonar, Sal. I'm like, got myself. I'm like, what more? We have, nobody has a limit on what we could talk about. So, you know, we are a hard group and a hard act. That's why we call it the Sports Circus. We are a hard act to follow.
Very hard act to follow. Because you know what's cool? What's cool about this, folks, here in our last minute? I mean, look, whether it's professional sports, whether it's business, whether it's music or film or law or science. Yeah. We've got these things covered in this team. And it's very hard to find, you know, Tyrone, you look at the different casts for the different shows that are out there for the most part. Now I see one cast on the Four Letter Network that features once in a while, Steve Young will pop on there. Super smart guy, super smart.
Yes.
But the balance of the team, the host, I got to tell you, in my opinion, not the smartest guys in the world, if you know what I'm talking about.
Exactly. And see, once we get E guys on this show, it's like, for those who are listening and looking, our show, when we get these guys come on this show, the Sports Circus, it's going to be like going home after that hard day of the tie, the jacket, whatever the case may be, and putting on your little hush puppies, relaxing in the recliner. This is what this show is all about. So that's why it's a hard act to follow, because we allow you to be who you are and say what you want to say.
That's right. All right, folks, back here with two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior Tyrone Poole and Sonar. He's not on our screen right now, but I'm sure he'll be back here in just a moment. All right, folks, don't go anywhere. Lots more to come. There he is.
There you go.
All right, buddy. Back here in a few minutes. Don't go anywhere. Lots more to come.
Can your IRA stand up to the next financial crisis that our top economists are saying is at our doorsteps? By allocating a percentage of your IRA into physical gold and silver with a tax-free rollover, you can diversify and safeguard your holdings from turbulent markets and economic downturns by putting your IRA back on the gold standard. Find out how to safeguard your assets with a tax-free rollover with a Genesis Gold IRA, the only IRA that can hold physical precious metals. Call now for your free gold and silver report. Protect your IRA today with one simple phone call and learn how to qualify for up to $10,000 in free silver. Call Genesis Gold Group, empowering faith-driven stewardship. 800-932-5517. 800-932-5517. 800-932-5517. That's 800-932-5517.
That's the sound of sizzling, dry-aged USDA Prime Wagyu and Angus steaks from UppercutChops.com. They're best-in-class filet mignons, New York steaks, and the king of all steaks, the tomahawk and cowboy cut ribeyes are the best in the business. Even their Prime Wagyu burgers will likely be the best you've ever had. Browse the full selection of steaks and chops at UppercutChops.com from the comfort of your home or on your mobile device. UppercutChops.com delivers all-natural, dry-aged USDA Prime Wagyu and Angus steaks and chops directly to your door, without the hassle of going to the grocery store and fight crowds to pick from a small selection of average and best meats with injected steroids, fillers, and coloring added to look good. Find out what's for dinner at UppercutChops.com or call 702-799-9935. That's 702-799-9935. 702-799-9935. Or make your selection directly at UppercutChops.com.
Hey, everybody, this is Barry Katz from the Industry Standard Podcast, and you're listening to the Sports Circus with Sal Tuzzolino.
Thank you.
That is not Tyrone Poole. That is Sal. This is Tyrone Poole. Welcome back to the Sports Circus. I am two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja. They do it to me all the time. American Ninja Warrior Tyrone Poole here with that guy you just saw earlier, Sal, and Sonar, who put Sal on. Together, we are working that thing for all those Amp TV, iHeartRadio, and all the hotel listeners. We hope that you are having fun. This segment coming up is brought to you by the TP38 Foundation, where we reform, refill, and restore people's lives. If you want to learn more about the Tyrone Poole 38 Foundation, go to TyronePoole38Foundation.org. There you can get all the information and you can donate to help us. So again, Sonar, are you going to put Sal up or you want me to stay up? So I'm like, you're the one pushing the buttons. You're the man. There we go. Hey, there goes Sal. I think Sal. Hey, there goes Sonar. Everybody point your finger at Sonar and say, get it right, Sonar. But welcome back to the last episode of the Sports Circus.
All right. A big welcome back to everybody listening in on Magic 97.9 FM right here in Las Vegas at our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast, as well as iHeartRadio, Spotify, Hotel Television, and Amp TV, AAMP.TV. You know, Tyrone, earlier today, before the show started, we were talking about, actually, this was last night, talking about like five different types of people.
Ooh.
Some to avoid, some to kind of latch on to. You know what I'm saying?
You want
to
go there? Woo, you want to go there? You think they can handle that, Sal?
Let's go. I want to go there.
I'm saying, the people, Amp TV and iHeartRadio, do you think they are ready, really ready to hear the five types of people that they will, if they have not already seen in their lives?
Absolutely. Really, and all we got to do, before you say it, I don't want to hear from the audience.
Stop whining.
Just knock it off and listen and keep your ear glued to that radio or keep your eyes glued to that television. Go ahead, Tyrone.
Ooh, well, we're going to start it off. Now, everybody, now listen up. So let me adjust my headsets here. I want to make sure I hear correctly. Got my mic because I want everybody to hear this right here. Now, there are five types of people that you are going to encounter. If you're living on this earth, if you're breathing right now, you have or you will encounter these five people. Now, the first person that you're going to encounter is going to be the predator. Okay. Now, before I get into all the other ones, understand all five of these people have a motive. And I'm going to let Sal venture in and talk about some of the people that he's met when I describe these people. And you listeners and viewers, you're going to say, oh, I know exactly what Sal and Tyrone and Sonar are talking about. Now, again, they all have motives, five people. The first one is a predator. Okay, the predator. We've all seen the wild. We've seen the lion as it sneaks up on its prey. And some of us, we've actually seen those lions in our lives. Now the lion, it'll creep up and then it'll get down in the brush. Now the prey, the gazelle or whatever it may be, looks up and it knows that it's something out there, but it just can't figure out where it is or what it's trying to do. Again, it has a motive. So again, the gazelle goes back to eating. The lion, it'll move a little bit closer, then get back down in the brush. And before you know it, the lion is pounced on the gazelle and the gazelle is either eating or running for its lives. That is what I call a predator. They are people in our lives that we're like, man, if I had known that's all he or she wanted it, I would have given it to him in the beginning. So guys, have y'all ever witnessed any type of predators in your life?
Oh yeah. Sonar, you go ahead.
No, I definitely had. And at the end of the day, what you should have given them in the beginning was just a finger, right? A specific finger. That's that's what they wanted at the end of the day anyway, right? Because that's what they got at the end of it, right? But you're right. Those predators out there, they're different than you and I. Like when I talk with you, Tyrone, it's we're sharks. We stay hungry, always moving, you know. That kind of thing. Those predators, what they'll do is they'll wait for you to do exactly what they want done, and then their faces turn. They're hiding in the brush, and they jump right up. You're right. You're absolutely right with that.
You know what they call them? I tell you what. You know what they call them, Tyrone? They call them biters. They take a bite out of you, and then they move on to the next one.
Move on to the next.
You know that term?
Exactly. Exactly. There you go. So in using the word moving on, how about parasites? Now, this one doesn't need to go into a long story. Parasites are who they are. They take from you more than they give you. So how many of us, I've come across parasites. How many of you guys, what watching us, listen to us, have come across parasites? So Sal, Sonar, any parasites in your life?
Sonar, go ahead.
Well, I mean, we all got a brother-in-law, right? No, I'm just no. And what I like about you comparing them is the difference between the two. A parasite is, oh, let me get a little bit now. Let me get a little bit now. It's the wimpies of the world, of the I'll gladly have a hamburger today and pay you next Tuesday type of thing. But it's the and those are the guys. Hey, a little bit, and then finally as the predator. Those are guys are different. They'll wait and then they'll jump on you as opposed to taking the little bit at a time. I like where you're going with this.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Sal?
And you know, the funny thing is with those parasites, as you move on in your professional career, like you, Tyrone, being on championship teams and being a part of one of the best cornerback tandems, arguably in the history of the game, with you and Ty Law. The fact is, people want to clamor on to the coattails. They want to just take a little bit of bite out of you here and there, you know, and that's really what this is about. We're going to just kind of nibble on you just a little bit, unlike the predators who will just blow everything up, right? As soon as they get what they want, they will sink the ship. They'll sink the world.
Yeah, the parasites, that's what they do. They take from you and they give you nothing. And next thing you know, you're caught up with everything, doing it yourself, and they're gone, moving on to the next elevator. Now, moving on to the next one. Now, we've all come across this one. Maybe this is the first one that we come across out of the five. Again, remember, we're talking about five people that you're going to encounter in your lifetime, or you've already encountered these five people, and they all have motives. They all have motives. Now, the next one, we talked about the predator. We talked about the parasite. The player. That person that plays on your whatever it is that you're passionate about. Any type of conversation you have with this person, they are always bringing that up. If you like going to the beach, then guess what? The opening part of their conversation is going to be, oh, I was just at the beach. Or they're going to say something about the sun, something about the sand. Or if you love your children, they're always going to have something talking about kids. But remember, they have a motive. So they're just trying to get close enough to you by playing on your emotions so they can get what they want. So, Sal, have you had any players? I've had players.
Oh, yeah. As soon as they come around, the first thing that comes out of my mouth.
Shut up.
I don't want to hear nothing out of them. Nothing. And I'll tell you why. Because every time they come around, it's like they show up with their hands out, but with their mouth. You know what I'm saying? So the first thing you're thinking about is,
hey, bud, what's your problem?
You know, something bad's going to happen because they're going to say this, that, just because that's what you want to hear. And all you're thinking in your brain, shut up. I'm going to knock you out. Get away from me. You know what I mean? And that's really how this stuff works. I don't want anybody near me like that. I don't want those people. It's basically the entourage, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep, that's a good way to put it.
It's the entourage. And you being on championship squads, you know, people will come around. They want to take a little bit of, hey, man, let's go to the beach. Let's have a beach party, whatever. But then they want you to pay for everything.
Yeah. And then they also play you, again, like you said earlier, to get to the next elevator. So they play you to get to maybe Tom Brady. Hey, Tyrone, you know, because they can't get directly to him. They try to come through me, or they try to come through somebody who played with him to play us to get to what their real motive is. So, Sonar, have you had any players in your life? Anybody try to play you to get something, get somewhere?
Tyrone, I would be honored if someone went through me to get to you, though. Come on.
Come on. Man.
I need that. Hey, you got Tyrone Poole's number, right? You got Tyrone Poole's number?
Yeah, you got it.
If I meet that guy, the one we're talking about, then I'm just going to send him away. Or I'll give him Sal's number instead.
Yeah. I'll give him my number.
Wow. Hey, Sal's bigger than me. Sal is bigger than me. I'm just trying to be like Sal. I'm in another life.
I'm just Sal's taller than you.
Top of the food chain here.
No. You're bigger than me. I'm just taller than you. That's all.
No. Well, hey, check this out. Moving on. Okay, we talked about three. Remember, we got five, okay? We talked about the predator. We got the parasite. We got the player. Now, if we have to say that these are negative, those are the three negative people that you'll probably come across. The last two, these two I call like twins. They're like twins. They look similar, but there is a difference. The last two are the participators and your partners. Now, I've gone to the point where I've learned that there are three different types of participators. Now, you got, in order, one being the most closest to being a partner. You got participator number two, participator level number three. So, but there is a difference that you can tell between all three because they each have a level, again, a motive. A participator three may say, I'm going to be with Sal or Sonar up until, say you got 100 range. And they say 55. If I don't get what I want at 55, then I'm going to move on to the next elevator. Well, participator number two may say, well, I'm going to go 60 out of 100. Participator number one may say, I'm going to do 75. Now, the reason why we in life, we sometimes tell participators partner information is because of the previous three I just named, the predator, the parasite, the player, because we had so much negative interaction with them, when a participator comes across, they give us more than we've expected. So we diverge more information to them, not realizing that they are what they are. Like Denny Green would say, God rest his spirit, they are who we thought they were. They are participators. So I've given information to people who I thought were partners, but they were just participators. So have you guys ever had any people that were participating in your life? They were good people, but you're like, oh, I thought you were a partner, but you're good people, but you're not quite that partner I thought you were.
Yeah. Yeah, I would say that. I would say I have. But Tyrone, listen, in the last 30 seconds, tell everybody about the last one real quick.
Well, the last one is the partner. The partner is the person that's going to be there for you. When you're up, they're up. When you're down, they're down. They're going to tell you the truth. They're going to yank you by the collar and say, hey, I'm not going to let you do that. They're the captain of the Titanic. They're going to go down with the ship. They're not going to bail. So those are the people that you want in your life. And you're lucky if you got two people. If you got one, if you got two, you're a very lucky man. Go play the lottery. Or woman, go play the lottery.
Sonar, go get a lottery ticket. Hurry up.
There's three.
Get a lottery
ticket. Yeah, there's three right now.
Exactly. All right, folks, that's going to do it for the circus today. I'm your Ringmaster Sal. Thanks for this guy over here, Tyrone Poole, joining us, two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior. Check him out at TP38. Is it TP38.com, right?
TP38 Foundation, Tyrone Poole 38Foundation.org.
All right, folks, we'll see you next time right here on your favorite station. Until then, so long, everyone.
Are you a small business owner or pursuing the dream of starting your own company? Do you know where to start or how to grow that existing business? The American Business Trust Company has the answers you need. The American Business Trust Company can help you with startup capital, business strategy, sales and marketing, and establishing your company with a physical location or on the internet. You decide. You bring the idea, the American Business Trust Company can help with the rest. For a free evaluation, you may visit them online at abtrustco.com. That's abtrustco.com, or call them at 657-600-1876. That's the American Business Trust Company, 657-600-1876. Call them today. They can help your business right away.